In this video, I'm going to show you how I set up my Stream Deck, and I'm going to leave a link at the bottom of the video so that you can download it and use it. I have the Stream Deck extra large. I think it's a little bit overboard, to be honest. If you don't have a Stream Deck yet and you're thinking about getting one, I'd probably get one a bit smaller because I use maybe like 6 buttons on it, but I also do have a panel. So just think about that. If you don't have a Stream Deck, you might get away with the smaller one. Let me show you how I set up mine though. This is the color page. And so on the color page, I have previous versions, I have next versions. Those ones I use quite a lot, maybe like middle. If you don't know what previous or next version is, it's pretty much this. Instead of left clicking, creating a new version, saying version 3, now you adjust it. I just go on my Stream Deck and I say, I'm gonna make a new version. New version is added. I make adjustments here. Let's go with something brighter and something cooler. Now on the Stream Deck, I just go next version and it'll just filter through all my versions or previous version. It's pretty handy to have. My pre node is pre node, any node before. My post node is any node after. And then obviously my parallel nodes. Those are the ones I use the most. I use parallel a lot. I don't really use layer nodes or outside nodes a lot, so I don't really use this on the Stream Deck. The other thing I really do use a lot though is at the bottom left, save memory and load memory. I'm just going to delete this. That comes in handy if you have a group of shots that have similar lighting, it's the same camera, and you want to copy over grades. All I do is I click on save memory 1, I go to the next shot, and then I say load memory 1. Now you're going to have to do adjustments here. Let's just add a node and go down with the gain. You're going to have to do some U stuff for the skin, but you get the idea. It copies over grades. I use this a lot. This is really, really handy. I don't really use the play or the stop or the review because I have the panel. But if you don't have the panel, this could come in very handy. On the next page, or it's actually on the previous one, on the page before this, I use that top section a lot. The bottom section is more for editing. It's shortcuts to blade and trim and copy and retime your timeline. I honestly don't really use it because I color grade 99% of the time unless I make these videos. But the top guys I want to talk to you about, they are incredibly handy. So you'll see it says like red, yellow, magenta, plus and minuses. All these are linked to my printer lights. If you don't know what printer lights are, it's pretty much adjustments over your entire footage in a certain direction. So it could be red, blue, yellow. If you go down here to the color, make sure your printer light hotkeys are on. And I have linked my Stream Deck to quarter printer lights. So it's the least amount of increments you can change it into a direction. I'm going to create a new node here. If I feel this image is too yellow and I want to reduce the entire image with a quarter printer light, to do it in your panel, your offset is incredibly hard. But because I linked it to my Stream Deck, it'll be very precise. I can go yellow, minus quarter, minus quarter, minus quarter, minus quarter, which would be 1. I can add green, quarter, quarter, quarter. I can decrease magenta. I can manipulate my entire image with these quarter printer lights in a very precise way. So they come in really, really handy. So that's my Stream Deck setup. Like I said at the beginning of the video, I will put a link at the bottom so that you can download it and play around with it, and hopefully it can improve your workflow.